Welcome to Sneak Peek. This is Rupal Purohit, and I have the creative Kida. Ziyad, the writer. So, writer is very creative. So, creative Kida is the word I can say for you. So, we have Gazal Dhaliwal. Oh, hi, and welcome to Sneak Peek.
Thank you.
So, what inspired you to write a story for a Monsoon Date?
I'm basically a big lover of the monsoon season. I'm really eagerly waiting for it to come. And I think everybody loves love stories. Everybody, basically we all like to have love in our lives. And it was a combination of both these things that went into creating a Monsoon Date.
Okay, so your film, Ek Ladki Ko Dekha To Aisa Laga, is on the same subject, on LGBT subject.
That's also LGBTQ, yeah. Yes.
And this Monsoon Date is also on the similar topic. So is it a conscious decision to write on same topic, or how it is?
So these are two films in my career which I've written around the LGBTQ subjects. I've written other films also, which is like Lipstick Under My Burqa, yeah, and Kareeb Kareeb Single. And they are in a completely different space. Having said that, I think that we still don't have enough LGBT films. In fact, far from it. We need to have lot many more films in this space. I actually wish many, many other writers and directors would make such films in our country. So I think I'm not doing enough. I think we are not doing enough.
So what was your reaction when our Supreme Court legalized LGBT and Section 377?
I was just thrilled. I was actually in some other city at that time. I was actually in Patiala, which is my hometown. And on the day when the result came, I wanted to be with all my LGBT friends in Bombay. So I took a flight on the same day. I came back, we had a big party. It was a really, really big day for the whole LGBT community in this country. But that was just the first step. We have a long way to go.
Oh yeah. So being a transgender, did you face any kind of problem in this industry?
As a trans person, I've not faced any sort of discrimination in the industry. Because, you know, the thing is that in our industry, there's anyway quite a few people who belong to this community, you know. So there is a sense of understanding and open-mindedness. So there are quite a few people in the industry. It's just that our films don't reflect that, because I think that becomes a business decision, because people think that, industry thinks that, you know, these subjects will not be accepted by the masses, and hence they don't make those films. But as a trans woman, I didn't really face any discrimination, so to
that's
say.
That's so wow, like that's so amazing.
Yeah.
So this section is already legalized, but there are still many people in our India who have not accepted the fact. So what do you think of
it? Actually, yeah, that's the major battle. That's the battle that we now have to fight. Because yes, legally it's not a crime. But the social fabric of our country still does not understand homosexuality or what being a transgender means. Mm-hmm. And now we have to reach out to the hearts and minds of those people. And telling stories is a very, very important way of doing that, which is why I'm stressing that our industry, our community needs to create more stories, tell more stories of this fashion, so that we can reach out to the social fabric of this country who are yet to accept.
So coming on the career life, so you, being an engineer student, you thought of moving to Mumbai, and you took admission in XIC college for writing for writing course. So then did you thought of this point of time, like you got break from Buzzer and then you started writing for Bollywood films. So did you thought of this time then?
Which time?
Now you are so famous writer, you have written so many films. So then when you started writing?
That time, see, when I started writing, that's, I mean, everybody hopes for that. I did hope that I would be able to write some good films, make some good, create some good work. And for some reason, I know people say that, you know, there's a lot of fate and luck which plays a part in this industry. And that is maybe true, but I just had this faith that I will get to a point where I can be proud of the work I'm doing. I didn't know how it would happen. I didn't know how much time it would take, but I knew that I was going to stay at it. I was going to continue working. And I'm just glad that I'm getting to do the work, the kind of work that I can be proud of.
Okay, so what inspired you to be a writer, being an engineering student? Like, engineering is so difficult and you did chemical engineering, so.
You know, I've just loved writing ever since childhood. That time I didn't think that I would make it my profession, that I would, you know, it would become career for me. I just was extremely fond of writing, so I just used to write. And then when I did engineering, I worked with Infosys for 2 years. Those 2 years I started feeling that, you know, this corporate job, I cannot do this for my whole life. I was not enjoying it. That's when I told myself that I shouldn't let go of my creative side. And then, so I decided to
good that you thought of that, or else this industry would have missed such amazing writer.
Thank you.
Coming back to the film, so how is this film special to you?
A Monsoon Date?
Yeah.
It's special in many ways, actually. It's special because of the people I got to work with. Tanuja Chandra is one of my dearest friends, and I love working with her. She's always encourages me. It's very inspirational. And then I got to work with Konkona for the very first time, who's just an, I mean, we all know she's a brilliant actress, but she's just a most outstanding person. She's just really kind, sensitive, and that's going to be one of my most memorable experiences of working on this film. And then, of course, you know, the story we're telling through this film is a very important story. It's again in the space of the LGBT community. And I think the stories of the LGBTQ community need to be told more and more and more. And that's also the reason it's special to me.
Okay. Being a writer, how did you feel when your short film was screened at MAMI and DFW South Asian Film Festival?
You know, I go to watch movies at MAMI every year, and it was just the greatest joy that my film was playing at MAMI, and you know, all the cinegoers came to watch my film, and it was a packed hall. Everybody watched it. And there was so much applause for the film, for the actors, and it was very, very fulfilling. I was very happy. I didn't get to go to the Dallas Film Festival, but I read some great reviews which came from there as well. It's just, it's a feeling of a lot of satisfaction when you read and when you come to know that people have connected with your film. It's like, you know, a film is a part of you in a way, a small part of you goes into that film. So it's like a validation of that part of you which you put into the film. Yeah, it feels great.
Lastly, what is your next project? Like, we are eagerly waiting for something more amazing from you.
I'm currently writing a show which is being produced by Ronnie Screwvala Productions. Oh. I can't tell you anything more.
Yeah, okay, no problem. We'll wait for that.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
It'll come next year.
Oh, it was a great conversation for with
Thank
you.
You.
And
Thank
I would, like, I personally don't like monsoon, but I would love to go on this date.
You must.
Monsoon date, yeah.
You must watch it.
Watch it. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.